Hello, this is Alejandro Sandoval with the Solo Negocios VideoBlog from June 25th, 2018, with a summary of the Solo Negocios Bulletin for today. The Mexican peso, for 7 days in a row, got appreciated again. And it was due mainly to the Bloomberg Dollar Spot Index that went down 0.23%, when in the past days also had the same effect. But today, specifically, the situation got weird because it had as origin mixed data from the US indicators, but there were other elements to be discussed in the following minutes. First, those indicators. New home sales went up 6.7% in May, when it was expected 0.8%, so it was a surprise, this result. But on the other hand, we had the Chicago Fed National Indicator for Economic Activity that went down 0.15 points in May. We have also in the forex market strong sales from higher risk assets like the Mexican peso, but it didn't happen specifically to Mexican peso. And the main data for today, the main news for today, was a trade war escalating given the tensions that had arisen from China and the US, specifically the US, preparing a document that will inhibit investments from China in technological companies in the USA, although the US Treasury said that they are not doing it specifically for China, but for any company that will intend to steal intellectual property in this technological sense. We'll see what happens with it. Then also they have information regarding their intention to impose tariffs on auto sales from the European Union to the United States. So both entities, China and Europe, stated that they will issue reprisals against the United States. So the trade war escalating, and this escalation will bring problems in terms of inflation into the US. If the dollar Bloomberg spot index still is going up as the trend of in the past days went down, but it still goes up, it will be like worse for the United States in terms of international trade, because their currency will be higher valued and then their exports will be more expensive and the imports into the US will be cheaper. So it's not necessarily the best scenario for them, but it's what they are causing because they are the ones originating this trade war without much of a chance of negotiation. They are more focused on the presumptuous deficit in the international trade balance of the United States rather than the whole context of elements involved in determining that international trade balance. What other information is important for the Mexican peso specifically? The support is 20 pesos per dollar, resistance 21 pesos per dollar at the wholesale market, but the trend, linear trend, still being negative for the Mexican peso. This means the depreciation is at hand, the slope of the interbank 30 days exchange rate, it's very high, it's almost 45% rates, so it's not the best scenario. Now, oil went down, you remember Friday, last Friday we talked about the OPEC agreement, the renewed OPEC agreement, let's say, to increase their production, but that they didn't like make the best communication available from the different countries that expressed how it resulted, because some of them talked about the 1.5 million barrels per day to be increased in the whole OPEC and allies scenario, but the other countries participating stated that they or even won't do it because they don't want to, or they cannot increase their production that much. Iran and Venezuela, given their sanctions imposed by the US, but the rest of countries, not necessarily because of willingness even, but mainly more linked to a situation of capacity and financing to do it. So it's kind of complex, the situation for OPEC and the oil market, which indirectly affects the Mexican peso because of the sales of Pemex, our oil national company, that goes directly as taxes, as income for the government, for the federal budget, and obviously it affects it. And when it goes up, it benefits the Mexican scenario of the government. But on the other hand, we get inflation. So the scenario is not the best one. And the Mexican peso has been appreciated a little bit, but the depreciation that we got from April to today is too big to be eased that easily. We'll have our election on next Sunday. We'll see what happens. But in the meantime, we will talk in the following days about this trade war, which is beginning to bring very hard implications into the world economy. Thank you very much for your attention. Bye-bye.